I'm Carlos Lopez Estrada, and I directed the music video for Groove Me for Maximum Balloon.
And I'm Christian Heuer, and I produced the music video.
I wanted to do a music video with green screens, but try to use them in some way that, you know, I haven't seen before. Don't get lost, we back in the city of the gems. Kiss me off till you get near the new city shop again. Help me down. We got the brief from the band of what they wanted to do, and all it said is there has to be a party, and we want angels and Vespas.
I think music videos are such a great way to start off in like production, especially like on the creative end and producing end, because you know you have small projects that you put together, you know, like one a week, one every other week, you know, and you can just really like focus on the project, like learn how to like tell a good story visually in a short amount of time. And then sometimes like a lot of directors integrate narrative elements, and then you can kind of just like develop your own style. Some people say, well, they're not on MTV anymore, like music videos are dead. But I mean, you can see videos like Justin Bieber's Baby that has like almost 600 million views online, which is, I mean, there's no way any music video was ever watched like to that exposure, you know, when it was on TV. Now, since they're online, they're like, you know, they're getting direct ad revenue. Music videos are actually making money for the first time in history. So, I mean, it's like not only are they just there, they're making the band money, they're making the label money, like it's visual exposure. The generation below us is becoming much more visually oriented, and who knows, you know, it could be the kind of thing where like every song eventually has some sort of like visual accompaniment.
I just think that music videos are such a good tool for bands to not only promote their material and their songs, but also to create an identity for themselves.